Hello friends, in previous videos, we have seen the general procedure to be followed for the design of filter. In that, we have seen the procedure for low pass, high pass, band pass and a band stop filter. It consists of first to find order of filter, second to design a low pass filter prototype, third, to transform this low pass filter prototype into a desired filter, and last, implement this in a real filter by using lumped component and a distributed component. In the next video lectures, we are going to solve some examples on these. Let us see the example 1. We are going to design a maximally flat low pass filter. So this is the problem: design maximally low pass filter which have cutoff frequency 2 GHz, impedance 50 ohm, and to get at least 15 dB insertion loss at 3 GHz. Solution. First, we write given data from a problem. They are given cutoff frequency FC, which is equal to 2 GHz, impedance R0 equal to 50 ohm. Insertion loss has given in terms of a dB, so PLR in dB is 15 dB and desired frequency F equal to 3 GHz. These are given data. With the help of these given data, we are going to design a maximally low pass filter. So as per discussion in a general procedure, step 1 is to find order of filter. For that purposes, we take the help of a formula. We know PLR is given as PLR is equal to 1 plus K square omega by omega C raised to n. But in a problem, PLR has given into the dB, but formula is in a normal scale. So our aim is to convert dB into the normal scale. So by using this equation, PLR equal to 10 raised to this 15 divided by 10. So this 10 raised to 1.5, using a calculator, the value comes 31.62. Omega by omega C, so 2 pi FC, 2 pi cancel, so 3 divided by 2, obviously answer comes, it is a 1.5 GHz. Now, put this value into the equation, put this value into equation, then equation becomes PLR 31.62. equal to 1 plus, you put k equal to 1, then omega by omega c to 1.5 raised to 2n, where we have considered k equal to 1. Take 1, this one to the left hand side, then it becomes 31.62 minus 1, obviously 30 minus 62. Equal to 1.5 raised to 2n. We are interested in a n. So to get this, apply logarithm on a both side. So applying log on a both side, we'll get log of 30.62 log of 1.5 raised to near. Now of 30.62 is 1.58 equal to right here 2n log of 1.5. Log of what take a log of 1.5 multiplied by 2, you will get only 0.352. So right here 1.48 equal to 0.352 n. So n equal to 1.48 divided by 0.352. So answer comes 4.20. So this is a n, but n is a integer. So if you take nearest value of 4.22, 20 is a 5. So n will take equal to 5. So what is the order of this filter? The order of filter is a 5, which gives information that in a circuit it requires the 5 reactive components. Okay. Next, we can also find the order of filter by using one alternative method. Now see which is that. You can also find it by using this graph. The graph gives information of attenuation versus frequency. If you see here, in that it has shown number of the graphs with value n. This n is called as the orders, n equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 up to the 10. Now see here on the x-axis, for computing the value of order, you should require a value omega by omega c minus 1. So I calculate here omega by omega c minus 1. Already we have calculated omega by omega c, 1.5 minus 1. How much it is? 0.5. So on x axis, we will get a value of 0.5. And our required value on y axis, that is attenuation dB. So attenuation in dB, or this called as PLR in dB, how much we require? It is a 15 dB. So I locate the intersection point of 0.5 and 15 dB. I find this is a 0.5, this is a 0.5, and this is a 15 dB. This is a here 10, 20. So we see this is a, okay, this is a 15 dB and this is a 0.5. See here this intersection point, this intersection value is a n equal to 5. Therefore right here from graph we find value n equal to 5. See here in a previous, by using a calculation, we got the value of n, that is order of filter is a 5. Here also we got a value, that is n equal to 5, meaning is that you can use any method for determining the order of filter. It depends on you. So next point is selection of filter coefficient. If we know the order of filter, then easily we'll determine the filter coefficient, that is G1, G2, G3, G4, G5 with the help of table. So I use this table to find the different filter coefficient. Table shows the value G0 is related to source resistance, so its value is a 1, because in the next step 2, we are going to design a low pass filter which has a normalized value by considering that is source resistance as a 1 and a cutoff frequency as a 1. Accordingly, we select G0 equal to 1 and omega c equal to 1. It is a normalized value, and this table is designed by calculating the value from 1 to 10. These are values to require the value for n equal to 5. So this is n equal to 5, then you get the value g1, g2, g3, g4, g5 and g6. So write here the components, or we say filter coefficients values from table. Each are both g01, g1, 0.61, 80, g2, 1.6180, g3, 2, g4, 1.6180, g5 equal to 0.6180, and what is the g6? g6 equal to 1. Means these are filter coefficient. So accordingly we design low pass filter prototype. If we know the low pass filter prototype, so what is the next step? In the next step, we will transform this low pass filter prototype to maximally flat low pass filter. How do we convert it? We convert it by using frequency scaling as well as impedance scaling technique. So we'll see. Step 3 is the transformation of prototype to desired filter using the frequency and impedance scaling. I draw the circuit diagram for that. Obviously, how many components are required? So, first component, 5 components we require, because n equal to 5, 5 reactive elements. So, first is C1 dash. Write this C1 L1 after that. First is C, then L, then C, then L, next C. So these are 5 components. Right here it is C1 dash, L2 dash, C3 dash, then L4 dash, then C5 dash. That's represent a design value elements. So 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. Next, we connect a source resistance here. It has a source resistance represented as RS dash. Then we apply a voltage source VS. This is a VS. We connect a load, that is a RL dash. Now our aim to calculate all these values. We will calculate now one by one. So what is first value now? First is RS dash. RS dash equal to G0 R0. What is the G0? 1, R0 is 50. So right here is a 50 ohm. Second value, C1 dash. C1 dash, how to write for C1 dash? G1 by R0 omega C. Put the value of G1, R0 and omega C, we get this value is 0.984 picofarad. Same part we will calculate L2 dash. L2 dash equal to G2 R0 by 100. I told that in impedance scaling, For inductor, we multiplied by a zero at the numerator, and in a C1 dash, we multiply R0 at the denominator. So put these values, then we'll get 6.438 nanohenry. Same part, we'll calculate next C3 dash, obviously G3 divided by R0 omega C, then C3 dash 3.183 picofarad, then L4 dash equal to G4 R0 by omega C. Put this value, we'll get answer 6.438 nanohenry. The next point, C5 dash equal to G5 R0 multiplied by omega C equal to its value 0.984 picofarad. Okay. Then next RL dash, how do you calculate RL dash? G6 multiplied by R0. Obviously R0 is 50, G6 is 1. So answer is 50. Thus we have calculated the component values. If we see carefully the component values, we find that C1 dash equal to C5 dash and L2 dash equal to L4 dash. So meaning is that whatever be the value you got as a C1 dash, we can replace this value as a C5 dash because both are same. L2 dash will be same as a L4 dash. L4 dash, it happens because if you see carefully the circuit diagram, it has a symmetrical components. Meaning that we don't calculate C5 dash and L4 dash. When you calculate C1 dash and L2 dash, you directly replace these values, you know, as a C5 dash and a L4 dash. It reduces the computational complexity. Okay, these are the values we got for a desired filter. Now, next step is the implementation of a filter. We implement this filter by using a lumped component. So, I draw a diagram. C, then L, in order of five reactive elements, then source register, VS light source, connect the load is a RL dash. So write all the values here. So write RS dash, it is a 50 ohm. C1 dash 0.984 picofarad. Then L2 dash 6.438 nanohenry. Then capacitor value, this value 3.183 picofarad. When you get 100, I told you that when you know the C1 dash, then easily you write to C5 dash. This is C5 dash, both are the same. I directly write 0.984 picofarad. And what is the value of this L4 dash? We know that this L2 dash and L4 dash both are same because both are symmetrical. So right here, this value is also 6.438 nanohenry. And what is Rn dash? Rn dash we have calculated, the value is 50 ohm. So this is a implementation of filter. Thus, by following the general procedure, we design any type of filter used for as a insertion loss method. Thank you.